In this video, we are going to establish the introduction to the statics analysis. And then we are going to start with the balance and forces and moments. In statics, the goal is to establish the relationship between these forces and torques and the forces amongst the moments that are applied to the end effector. There are several methods to solve this problem. We have the vector approach and the virtual work methods, among others. With the joint reactions, this is a result that is used in the right size selection of the links and actuators. Now, in this course, we are going to use the Jacobian matrix approach that is used in the virtual work method. So, when we are talking about the static, we also relate with equilibrium, a balance, in this case, between the virtual work that we have for the effects and the end effectors robot and the joints. That's in a mathematical formulation, we can establish these equations. So this term here, W, represents the end effector range. Range includes all the external forces that are applied in the end effectors, forces and moments. The delta X represents all these virtual work displacement. Tau is the joint torques, and delta theta is going to represent the joint virtual work displacement. We have here the dimensions. All these are matrices, so the dimensions are a relationship between the end effectors, virtual works. That's we have, that's why we could include these m coordinates values, and the another size is with the n joints variables. Now, we also know that this displacement in the n effector robot can be also related with the direct velocity model using this formulation, where, as we remember, we need to include the Jacobian matrix, because Jacobian matrix is going to map in all these distance, change of distance that we have between the end effector motion with the joints motion. Now, again, we have the dimensions for these components. In this case, remember the Jacobian matrix is a m by n matrix. In general form, Jacobian could be a no square matrix. Now, let's recall our virtual work formulation and then substitute this virtual displacement in these equations. And then we obtain this this mathematical relationship using our dimensions of this matrix. Now, in this case, we are going to eliminate these both sides of this equation using these reductions using the right matrix operations. As we can hear, at the end, we can eliminate these two components for the both sides of this matrix equation. And then, finally, we obtain this relationship, where also is give you this relationship between the torques and the end effector forces that are applied using the Jacobian matrix. Then, for this equation, we apply now the transpose on both sides of these equations. And using these matrix properties, we finally obtain our statics formulation for a serial robot.